When we are developing applications that are based in the HTTP protocol, sometimes it's very important to know how to read the fields that are present in the HTTP headers of the requested HTTP package. So in this video, we are going to see how to, using the Spring Boot for the backend technology, we can read the fields that are available in the HTTP request header. So let's take a look here in the front-end client first. Basically, here we have one web browser, and when we look to the network tab of the developer console and we make a new request, let's take a look in what was requested. We have the response headers and we have also the request headers, and here you can see we have a lot of fields as what kind of content we accept, what are the accept encoding we are using, and what are the cookies that we are going to send to the backend, and a lot of other fields that are available to be read by the backend. It could, for instance, make some kind of controlling or detect how the algorithm in the backend will be processed. The HTTP response headers could be used as input information for the algorithms in the backend. So, okay, it means our informations we have here as look user agent, we can know what are the browser the user is using to perform the requests, for instance. So all this information here we can use to make processing on backend. So what is the challenge here? How in the backend we can request to the frontend information what was the user agent, for instance. Now let's take a look in the Java code using the Spring Boot. Basically here we have one REST controller class, and then we have one method that is mapped to this endpoint we are testing here. And then we can, in the parameters of this method, make one mapping of one parameter variable with one request header field. So we could have how many fields we want to. Look here, what this method do? It receives the parameter in mapping the HTTP header field and print that in the console. So let's do one different thing here. Let's take a look in what are the informations. And now let's try to hit the user agent. Let's identify in our backend what's the user agent that's being used to perform the request. So we can create here one second parameter. I can just copy and paste this first one. Let's do that together and take a look. Then we just replace the header field here, right? As it was there available, we can change that to any name you want to, like user agent in this case. And then we can, in this short example, just present that in the console of the backend. So here we can say user agent. And now we are going to present the user agent also in the console. Let's see if this code will work. So we have to stop the current executing code. Let's clear that and let's start our project again with this new code. And then let's wait to see what is going to be the behavior, if the new variable is going to map with the corresponding HTTP header field. Okay, so it has started. Now let's perform a new request. Okay, it was done. It has answered with success. And let's take a look here. Can you see in the interface here, in the very bottom, we have the language and we have the user agent also available. That's highlighted here in the text. So here it is, a way that using the Spring Boot framework, we can read the request header fields of the HTTP requests our backend service is receiving. One example of this code is available to be downloaded at the video description. Thank you for watching.